Shellharbour City Council says it's secured the future of the Lynx Golf Course in Shell Cove, with councillors voting last night in favour of a new business plan. The plan will see the ninth hole subdivided and sold off, and the possible construction of a new drive-through bottle shop.
Shellharbour Council says it's a hole-in-one deal for the future of the Lynx.
Council has committed to the golf course and committed to the golf course being a golf course for the immediate future.
The course had been draining up to $300,000 a year since Council took it over in 2008. In April it sought a private buyer, but there were no takers, so now it's come up with its own plan.
Since we haven't had a successful tender, we would cease that process and that we would now develop a business plan for the future of the Lynx.
That plan will see the ninth hole, which runs along Dunmore Road, subdivided into 42 new private lots to be sold off. There are also proposals to introduce poker machines and possibly build a drive-through bottle shop. It's an issue for independent councillor Peter Moran.
We're doing it on the backs of the people in the community who have gambling and alcohol problems.
Architects and golf course designers have already been called in to help redesign the course.
Them and I and some other people firmly believe that it will actually improve the golf course.
But while council says the changes will improve the links, not everyone is convinced.
No, I love the ninth, yeah. It's what, second hardest on the course? So it's, yeah, I would hate to see it go.
And I don't think you need a drive-through. There's plenty of other places you can get a drive-through.
Rob Morrison, Wynn News.
The Stop the Hub group will have its petition against the controversial City Hub project in Shellharbour debated in State Parliament in November. The group is fighting against the $58 million facility, which will include a new council chambers and library. Headed by former Mayor and Shellharbour Councillor Kelly Marsh, the group reached 10,000 signatures and presented it to Parliament last week. The petition will be debated on the floor on November 13.
Tributes have flooded in for one of Australia's best-known clown doctors from Barrel, who lost his battle with cancer on Friday. Peter Spitzer, also known as Dr. Fruitloop, used humour to help people in their recovery in hospital. He was the co-founder of the Humour Foundation, established in 1997. Since its establishment, around 150,000 patients have been visited by the colourful characters. Peter is being remembered as a wonderful doctor and a man who will be sorely missed.
The Illawarra community is rallying to give a brave little boy and his family a new home. Three-year-old Dexter Heffernan is severely disabled and needs a specially designed house to better accommodate his needs.
The call for tradies went out.